slot.
Could have been something, couldn't it?
Don't push it in and I'll count it down.
Sorry.
He's got his game face on now. Happy, smiling Andy has suddenly gone very sullen and determined.
I think Andy Pyrus missed his calling. He is. This is world class. He's going to pick up 40,000 here. Dave Gregory can't call this.
All in for 105 more. Fold.
Well played, Andy Pyra. That was tremendous. There's me saying he'll put it down. He goes well over the top and takes the pot. Fantastic poker.
My lord! That's the strongest play we've seen at this table. It was terrifying. Stultifying.
No one to play with? There's always partypoker.com.
So there's just not much room for maneuvering right now. It's the blinds are about to go up, and it's going to become just a question of the cards and a strong right arm, I think.
When it gets like this and a lot of players left, it virtually becomes a crapshoot as the blinds get higher, doesn't it, Jesse?
Well, until we lose the next two players. I mean, I don't think we're going to be seeing many flops from here on in, possibly until it's three-way. That's what you do. And of course, we're about to see one now. I'm a lovely prognosis.
Prognosis is a good word, eventually.
I have a big probosis, I think. That's what I wanted to say.
Oh, it's huge. Now, what's Robert Cooper going to do? He's missed every flop when he's limped. And he's missed another flop when he's limped.
Yeah, this is just a situation. Ken Broad on Bob Cooper. And, one time that Bob Cooper tried to bluff Ken Broad, he was caught.
This is deja vu. This is deja vu. This is deja vu.
Okay.
Check.
He's going for the five. Five would make Bob Cooper a straight, and he is hoping against hope.
He's hit a pair.
Might be enough.
15,000.
But as usual, it's Ken that bets out. When he's missed completely, Bob's hit, and the history tells you that Bob will now pass his cards.
Yeah, I mean, in some ways you'd think it's automatic all in, but Bob just believes.
Fold.
I'm sighing for Bob.
No, don't show him! Oh, Ken! Oh, that was cruel. Oh, that was kicking a man when he's down, isn't it?
Oh, Bob Cooper now feels like a toddler with no nappy.
Oof.
That was humiliating and belittling, and I know how Bob feels now. He's pretending it doesn't hurt him, but it hurts him deeply inside. Ken's got his measure. That happened to me at the EPT tournament in Dublin when I folded top pair to a big bluff and the bluff was shown and I couldn't think straight for 15 minutes. I felt ashamed. Ashamed of myself.
The steam coming out of your collar.
Well, I just didn't have the chutzpah to do anything about it. I should have re-raised or I should have called, but I was scared.
It's a strong move in poker.
Oh.
It's not below the belt, but it's certainly around that area.
Now, you see, Ken may be wearing pink, but I wouldn't want to meet him down a dark alley.
No. And I think there was some thought behind it. Ken is ready to really shake this table up. And he wants to put the fear of God in them.
Cool.
Or the fear of Ken, anyway.
Which is probably slightly more intimidating under the circumstances tonight.
Well, Bob Cooper has he's peeling off a flop here with the 8-deuce. Pyra in the big blind with a 7-9, and Ken Broad has got the 2-3s. They've all missed. Although Andy's
hit a pair of 9s.
And a flush draw. Oh, no. I think there are three clubs out there.
All in.
Oh, what a big move by Andy.
Fold.
With bottom pair. He has shown guts tonight, hasn't he? Some might say foolishness, but yeah, no.
It's a great line to walk, isn't it?
Yeah. He's walked it very well, because every time he's made the move, nobody's had anything worth calling him with.
So the blinds are just about to go up. Let's take a look at how the blinds work in Texas Hold'em. Every poker hand begins with the placing of the button and the posting of the blind. The button is a disc that represents the nominal dealer. The blinds are forced bets to get the action started. The player to the left of the button puts in the small blind. The player on his left puts in the big blind, usually double the small. Action for this first round of betting will move to the left of the big blind. The button moves to the left with each hand, and the blinds are raised throughout the game to keep the action going.
What was that? Fake.
I might even call him. Oh, no.
Just for you.
Cool.
Hello, new tactic, Andy's limping.
That's unorthodox.
Pass.
Maybe he was worried too many players acting behind him, didn't want to commit too many chips, but
pass.
It's a weak thing to do.
In some ways, it looks very strong. That may be what the other player... I mean, Dave Gregory just folded an ace there.
And no raise.
But Ken's going to have a look.
Yeah, it's the kind of thing that needs to be strong, isn't it? Because he's given these guys a free flop, and now Broad has hit top pair. Oh, he's going to...
He's sucking him in.
Check.
And he's likely to bet at this.
Check. Check. All checks.
Oh. No bet.
Pyra looking for the ace.
Oh, ho. Ken Broad is going to be very upset that he checked that flop, Jesse.
Check. Check.
There's too much money out there to leave behind.
Andy likes to put those red ones in the middle.
715.
It's going to be tough for Ken Broad to lay this down.
15,000.
Nice, bet the minimum. I think Ken's going to have to look at this. He may even re-raise.
This is a really big decision for Ken Broad. If he goes blood to the head here.
But if he goes over the top, Jesse, would Andy think his kicker was no good? Maybe he was he'd be thinking Queen Jack.
It's very reasonable, actually.
Mm. Queen Jack is the kind of thing you want to see a flop with at this stage, isn't it? And Andy didn't raise before the flop, so he's given that kind of hand an opportunity to see a flop.
Well, Ken's giving himself every opportunity to get some information from Andy. And he's decided that Andy is not strong. We'll have to see if Andy can stand this raise. Oh, he hasn't decided anything yet, has he?
He's threatening, though, Jesse. I know what you mean. Two little piles there. Looks about 30,000 chips.
Oof. He just smells something a little bit rancid. That was a very classy fold.
He obviously smelt something there. Maybe it was Andy's limp from under the gun there that made him think of a very, very strong hand.
Yeah. Two little slices of orange and red. David Gregory, Bob Cooper have their work cut out for them here.
Andy Pyra with the purples. He'll be very, very pleased.
Oh, Bob Cooper is all in on the big blind. This is what you don't want to have happen to you. Cooper, it's 15,000 for the big blind, but he's gone all in on the blind with his remaining 6,000, saying no matter what, he's calling. And they call that the Calacus, I believe.
Oh, the Calacus. Well, the Calacus has come up against the big slick.
For 41,000. Pass. Pass.
There are sixes. You're good.
And it's the two low stacks, but we have a race.
I tell you what, Dave Gregory must feel like he is due to beat Bob Cooper in a race. This is number 3 with the cards.